Modern Warfare 2 Season 4 is now live, and we're going over all of the patches associated with the new 1.20 update and taking a look at everything that's changing here in Season 4. If you guys want to stay up to date with any and all news as well as updates, make sure you guys drop a like on the video, subscribe the channel, and turn those post notifications. Let me know down in the comment section, after going over the patch notes, is this update a W or a complete L? We're starting off with the weapons because that's what's important here. You guys can see we are getting the Tempest Razorback Assault Rifle. It's going to be a 5.56 weapon. It's going to be a mixture of the M4 as well as the TAP-56, fast fire rate, very low recoil. We're also getting the ISO 45. This is going to be, again, a high fire rate SMG. It's going to be similar to the ISO we saw in Modern Warfare 2019. So if you like that gun in that game, you should be in for a nice surprise here. Now, we also are getting the Tonfa melee weapon, and we are getting a shotgun within the mid-season update. Now, we are going to be discussing the weapon balance because that's very important and crucial when discussing the potential meta shift within Season 4. Now, weapon balancing. These changes to player health and application of armor damage ultimately result in the time to kill feeling slower, more consistent, and more reactable in every engagement distance. Now, while a select few weapons are listed below, it is important to note that most weapons see their effectiveness altered as a result of the change to armor damage. For now, we will be retiring the term armor damage. Any future changes that we are Warzone specific will be falling by Warzone only. Okay, so that's just going to be obviously Warzone only changes. Now, for battle rifles, we have the Cronin Squall, full auto mode, bullets to kill increased by 2. This is going to be in Warzone only. Maximum damage increased, Warzone only. Minimum damage added, Warzone only. So the Cronin Squall is only getting touched in Warzone, it looks like, and they're not making any changes within multiplayer. Okay, semi-auto mode, bullets to kill increased by 1, obviously Warzone. Maximum damage decreased, that's going to be in Warzone only. And minimum damage increase, this is also going to be Warzone only. So this weapon is only getting changed in Warzone, which is actually pretty interesting. Again, here for the shotguns, the Bryson 800, this actually is getting changed within multiplayer. So minimum damage decreased, this is going to be Warzone only. Headshot multiplier increased, neck multiplier increased, upper torso multiplier increased, arm multipliers increased, and leg multipliers increased. So the Bryson 800 received a buff, a massive buff, here in multiplayer, which is actually quite alarming. This was already a pretty solid shotgun. I think they're going ahead and kind of making the pump action shotguns a little bit more viable, because we do have quite a few semi-automatic options available that are arguably better as of right now. So for the Bryson 890, this is going to be in Warzone only. Minimum damage has been decreased. And for multiplayer, head multiplier increased, neck multiplier increased, upper torso multiplier increased, arm multipliers increased, as well as leg multipliers increased. So the Bryson 890, as well as the 800, the pump action shotguns, they got buffs here in multiplayer. That's very interesting. Let me know down in the comment section what you guys think about this. Now, we have another shotgun here, the Expedite 12. This is going to be Warzone only. Minimum damage added, that's going to be Warzone, and leg multipliers increased. So all the shotguns are seemingly getting buffed here in multiplayer, which is very, very alarming here. I did not expect this to happen within Season 4. Now, we have the KV Broadside, arguably the best shotgun in the entire game. I feel like they're going ahead and buffing all the other shotguns because of the KB Broadside being semi-automatic and being so damn effective. Now, mid damage decreased. So the KV Broadside luckily received a nerf. That's going to be a huge W in my opinion. We're not done here. Damn, more shotguns. The Lockwood 300, minimum damage has been decreased in Warzone. Head multiplier increased, neck multiplier increased, upper torso multiplier increased, arm multipliers increased, leg multipliers increased, hip to AES spread transition speed increased, becomes accurate faster after aiming down sights, mid damage range increased, mid damage decreased slightly. So the Lockwood 300 received a colossal buff here in multiplayer. That is very, very interesting here. Wow. They just went overkill with the shotguns, in my personal opinion. Let me know down in the comment section. I did not expect that to happen. Typically, we see changes like this made to the AR and SMG category. Now, submachine guns. The Fennec 45. Bullets to kill decreased by one. This is going to be in Warzone only. So the Fennec got touched. Again, this is going to be the only weapon in the submachine gun category that touched. Wow, that's crazy. They didn't touch the Vaznev 9K. They didn't touch the Lachman sub. I am shocked. I know a lot of you guys are probably as well, because they have been touching those weapons literally every single update. Now, attachments. Here we go. There are new attachments teased in the Battle Pass trailer. Now, for the FTAC Siege, we have an akimbo option. This is going to be unlocked through an in-game challenge, 25 hip-fire kills with the FTAC Siege. So the akimbo FTAC Siege is going to be an option here in Season 4. The Cast-Off 74U, we have a new attachment for this. I was not expecting this. This is going to be the KSTV 17 barrel. They added the Cast-Off 74 progression, replaces the 545 tracer at level 9. Players who have progressed beyond this level will have it retroactively granted to their account. Okay, so we already have it unlocked. So if you have the Cast-Off already unlocked, already maxed out, you have this attachment already, which is going to be a massive W in my opinion. KV Broadside, another nerf. The 12-gauge Dragon's Breath, close range damage. They didn't. They buffed the KV Broadside's Dragon's Breath. That is insane. Whatever, man. They buffed the KV Broadside's Dragon Breath. So that is actually wild to my opinion. Wow. So that's going to be all of the weapon balance changes within Season 4. That's wild. You guys can see here, the Cronin Squall Battle Rifle only got adjusted here in Warzone, but literally the shotguns got a massive, and I mean a massive amount of love this season. Holy. And we have the new attachment on the FTAC Siege as well as the Cast-Off 74U. Let me know down in the comment section what you guys think about this, man. This is very interesting. I was actually not expecting patch notes like this season. I know a lot of you guys are probably going to be blowing up the comment section talking about, why are shotguns getting buffs? Where are the changes to the ARs and SMGs? But I think they are betting. Let's go back to the Battle Pass unlocks. So the ISO 45 is going to be a D19. So you get this in tier 19, and you get the Razorback at D13. So they are literally betting that the Razorback as well as the ISO 45 kind of make their way into the AR and SMG meta, and they're solidified in the current meta that we have in the game right now. So they're not betting that they need to go ahead and change any of the other weapons in the game. That's what I'm assuming is going to happen, and what they're praying happens, because this is probably the first update that we have not seen major changes to ARs or SMGs. So again, let me know down in the comment section what you guys think. We're gonna have to see how this all plays out. But if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you drop a like of the video, subscribe to the channel, turn those post notifications, and let's jump right into Season 4.